I'm Brian, and today I want to go over quickly how you can use LaunchDarkly with TypeScript. While LaunchDarkly doesn't provide a native TypeScript SDK, we'll see how the current Node SDK provides types that make it easy to integrate into a TypeScript project. We'll also explore how you can use our client-side SDKs in a React or Next.js project built with TypeScript. So let's get started. This first example, I've just built a simple project using TypeScript that loads in the Node.js SDK and logs the value of a flag. First, we need to import the Node.js SDK, which you can see I've done here. As you can see, the SDK provides type definitions that we can use when we're working with the SDK. For example, an instance of the SDK client would be launchdarkly.ldclient. The user type, which you provide to the SDK to do things like user targeting, would be of type launchdarkly.lduser. And finally, if you receive a response from a LaunchDarkly flag value, it would be type ldFlagValue. You can explore these types via IntelliSense, as you can see here. Since this is a very simple example, we can just compile it and then run it. And you can see that I've got the value of the flag that I'm console logging here for featured username. Let's see how you can use the LaunchDarkly client-side SDKs with a project using TypeScript. This example is just a basic Next.js blog boilerplate using TypeScript that I've integrated the LaunchDarkly React SDK into. As you can see, I've imported it here with the with LD provider to wrap my application, but I'm getting a couple of compiler errors here that I need to resolve. These are pretty easy to resolve. First of all, when I'm passing the client-side ID, all I need to do is add an exclamation point here to indicate that this value will not be undefined. Now, I've also got this type issue with my app. So I've already imported the component type I need here. So I just have to coerce my app into component type like so. Save it, and now we have no compiler errors. And if we go into one of the application's pages, you'll see that I am using with LD consumer to wrap the page component and consume the flag values. I can now log the value of my Boolean flag called rebrand. Note that you can use the use flags hook here as well if you prefer. So let's just quickly run the project to show you that everything is working as expected. As you might have noticed, we're getting undefined in the server console for the flag value, but that's expected since it's actually a client-side value coming from the client-side SDK. Let's view the page in the browser instead. Let's open up the developer tools and open our console. You'll see that the value of the flag is actually false when console logged in the browser. Well, that's it. As you can see, if you're looking to use LaunchDarkly in your TypeScript project, it's pretty easy to do. I hope you found this helpful. See you later.